This is Family Worship Experience International, a place of worship, word, and intimacy. Join us as we take a walk into the life-changing Word of God with Apostle Jonathan Shokonya.
What is open? I came hungry to receive. I came with a desire to receive. There is no distance. You are inside, you are outside. Following online, there is no distance. Come and talk to the Lord. My heart is open. My spirit is open to receive of you. Shabarada bako sabalataya. Kabrande ko sobalata pregatila. Zekete barada bakonto presketa. Lekabarande skoprate katilaka. Come on, can you take 1 minute, drop your spirit? Let your heart truly be open. Lord, tonight my heart is open. Lord, tonight my spirit is open. Lord, tonight I came as a receiver. I came to receive. Shatabarande kaprotos tabaladabaya. Let the channels of your spirit be open. Let it be open. Let it be open. Let it be open. Let it be open. Caprondos cope legatia. Ratatatabacabarada bacoso blatica. Oh, blessed be the name of the Lord. Thank you, Lord, for the things you will do and you are doing already. In Jesus' mighty name. Amen. All right, before you sit down, I want to specially welcome everybody to 2020 edition of Young Ministers Conference. Amen. Hallelujah. And I want to believe that you are here full of expectations. And God is set to meet us. Believe me that no one will meet the same. Before the end of all the sessions we have, that your spirit will truly carry something. And you will go back and never be the same. I want to specially welcome all the ministers that travel from various states, believers from all around the nation. You are all welcome. I can see a lot of you. I celebrate you. A lot of you questioned with you. I'm surprised. God bless you. Thank you. I know some of you might be seated at the overflow. Tonight, I don't want you to truly mind the place you are seated. We know you are a man of God. We honor and respect you. Sincerely with you. I have to take our time to do this. But I want you to truly be a receiver. That the things you are hearing might not necessarily be new, but they are coming with an urgency of the Spirit. They come with an impartation. I've said it again and again. We listen for two reasons, to learn and to be imparted. A lot of people listen just because they want to know the recent revelation. But beyond that, we also listen for the sake of impartation. That each time the word of God comes, it comes with the Spirit behind it. He said, as that word entered me, he had the ability to set me on my feet. Tonight, that's what the word of God is going to be doing on all the sessions we have. Hallelujah. So I want you to lift your hand one more time and say, Lord, I'm here as a receiver. I'm here to receive. May my life never be the same. May my life never be the same. And in the next 1 minute, can you talk to the Lord about that? Come and pray. You are following online from within the nation, outside the nation, Nigeria. Pray. There is no distance. Pray. Come on, are you praying inside, outside? Rapatabate caprons capriata cabalagadadadesh. Come on, believers, are you praying? Ratabalato braskila bababae. Ashana namate cobarande caprati caledebekeshata. I can see with the eyes of my spirit. I can hear A sound of a mutual marching. I can hear they are coming in their thousands. They are coming from afar. They are coming from afar. Oh, come and pray. Oh, 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 oh. So young ancient arise. There's a clarion call. Young ancients in worship. Young ancient, the spirit of Yeshua is on you. Stronger than Moses, I can see a generation stronger than Elijah. I can see they are coming in their thousands. They are coming from afar. They are coming from afar. Hey. Let her bring the Kosova Lada Babri and the best. Shatabalada bring the Katilaka. There is an emergence. There is an emergence. There is an emergence. Shatete Barada Bakatela. Rokopo Kosova Lakatea. Na 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 na. Oh, 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 oh. Father, tonight our hearts are open, and there is indeed an emergence of an army. And we are glad to be part of this army. Joto barada babayeka bashataya. Blessed be the name of the Lord. In Jesus' mighty name. There is a generation arising. A strong people. A mighty people. And I'm glad that you are part of this. I'm glad you are part of this generation. Lord, tonight our hearts are open. Do with us what it pleases you. In the name of our Lord Jesus. Amen and amen. All right, please just be still. I'm seeing a young man outside. I had a vision while I sat down here. And this is going to be a sign for the teaching to continue now. He's really outside. He's not even inside. There is fire coming on you. And listen, you won't be able to hold it. It's literal fire. You can't stand it. That is this. Please, when it happened to that young man, let me have him inside. people will try to hold you, they can't hold you. It's a dimension of fire. Until this happens, the teaching cannot continue. And Lord, wherever the young man is, change his life. And let it prove to us that you are visiting us tonight. In the name of the Lord Jesus, touch him right now. Visit him right now. Paratabako sobrande ketilaga. Jatabarana brande keskobalana pregedededevesha. Jata katabala brande ketila. Jatabarana da 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 da. When you are here, 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 when the hand of God comes on him, let me have him inside. When you are here, when you are here, when you are here. When you are here, hey, na na na, salada barada diata, hey, salada da 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 di o salama na na, salada barada da diata. Let a brande consubrati ki balada braya. Venimau sobrikalina ma. Reketi ki balada brasha brata baladededesh. Enkrato la bras ki balada braya. May your life be changed and never be the same. Please can you be seated if you can. Just be seated. How do we know that the Lord is in our midst? These are the signs and the wonders. Spirit of the unseen one, God will see the firmament, your presence known to me. The glory of the Spirit of the ancient King, come and make your presence known revealed by the Lord. I held the lion, I held the lion, I held the lion. Hallelujah. The book of Joel, chapter 2. Please be seated. Let's try to consider a few things tonight. The emergence of the revivalist. I'm talking on the emergence of the revivalist. Just hold them. Reva tabasuba katiki baladaga. Hari Hari Yo, Hari Hari Yo.
Hari Yo.
Hari Hari Yo. Hari Hari Yo. Listen, please be seated, please be seated. Father, may your light never be the same. In the name of the Lord Jesus. Please be seated wherever you are. Our generation is such a prophetic generation. Let me start from here. So prophetic that Jesus himself started saying that kings and prophets looked forward to our days. That there was something about our generation that interested them. They wanted to see it. They wanted to enter it. They could not. And the gateway was supposed to be Jesus. But they earnestly desired it. For many of them that truly walked with the Lord and were passionate about these things, they were able to open a vista in the realm of the spirit that granted them access to seeing certain things. For instance, David, the Bible says he was able to see certain realities that were not meant for his generation. And then he started writing the song, the Lord said to my Lord, sit thou at my right hand until I make your enemies come under your footstool. These were realities that were not allowed for their generations, but that their hunger was able to make them press beyond the things that were available for them. Our generation is so profound that many prophets all through scripture keep prophesying. In the last days, this and that will happen. And hope you know that we are truly in the end of the age. We are. We are. Jesus himself prophesied about this generation. He told us that when this season comes, we will do greater works. It was still part of the prophecy for our generation. We will do greater works. We will walk in dimensions of the spirit. We will open realities that have been hidden and allowed for a time as this. And all of these are pertaining to our generation. I'm so glad to be part of this season. And listen, although I know that our generation is a generation that will bring the close of the age, and I want you to believe this, that our generation is a generation, please just help them. Our generation is a generation that will usher in the coming of the Christ. I've said this a couple of times, and I want you to believe this. It's not a lie. It's not a lie. We are the one that will bring the end of the close. We are the one that will usher in the Christ himself. And that's why the things that God will be doing in our generation, in our age and time, eyes have not seen, ears have not heard, it has not even entered into the heart of any man, the things the Lord is preparing. Believe it. And listen carefully. A lot of people prophesy this, not even just in Bible days. One of the men that prophesied this was men like William Seymour, the young lady that did the spoken words, talked about him. In 1906, listen carefully. I know the power of God is going to be touching people as I teach. And I don't plan to shout. I want you to pay attention. If someone is under the anointing around you, please help them. Be your neighbor's keeper. We don't have to allow this place to become rowdy. In 1906, listen carefully. There was a revival that broke out in the United States, popularly called the Azusa Street Revival. And before that man went to be with the Lord, listen carefully to my story. Don't be distracted. It's not really an organized meeting. Just follow us. Before he went to be with the Lord, he kept prophesying that the Lord assured him that there is another revival coming that is greater than the Azusa Street. There is a revival coming. He kept saying it again and again. again and again. And listen, there was accuracy tied to that prophecy. He said in exactly 100 years' time that revival will hit the earth and it will be greater than the Azusa's. And hope you know the kind of revival that happened in the Azusa's too. Let me even give you a little, a lot of you have read about it. It was a terrible revival that if you had problem with your wife, you can't enter the church. The power of God will keep you out of God. Don't enter the church when you had a grudge with your wife. You don't pretend in that meeting. The power and the presence of God was usually so powerful and tangible. Not all of these things we do here and there and say, I can feel the presence and there is nothing there. It was something that was so palpable. People come into the door and they literally can collide with the presence of God. And listen, the amazing part of this revival again is that there was usually a literal fire on the roof. Literal fire on the roof. And listen carefully. The stories and the testimony shows that there was a fire that was on the roof. And there was another fire when the meeting becomes intense. It drops from heaven. And it could be like 50 feet tall into heaven. So all around the city, people could see what's happening. On so many occasions, they have called fire service to come and quench the fire. Only for them to arrive and realize it's not even literal fire. That's how powerful that revival was. People traveled around the world just to come in that environment, to touch that dimension of fire, and then go back with it to their various places. And the same revival spanned. And that man told us that the Lord showed him that in exactly 100 years' time, there is a greater revival hitting the earth. And that revival will usher in the coming of the bride himself. From 1906 till now, it was celebrated a few years back in the United States, for many of you who are following prophecy. I've been a student of revival myself. It was celebrated 3 or 4 years back in the United States because it was accomplished. And that revival didn't last long. It only lasts for 3 years. But that which is hitting our generation will last until Jesus appears. It's not going to be a revival that will be corrupted by the frailties of men, no. It's not going to be a revival that will be corrupted by our limitation, no. The one that is going to be behind this revival is the Spirit of God himself. Believe it. It has been tried again and again. Some few months back, I don't think it's up to a year. A great man of God again went to be with the Lord, Maurice Sorolo. And before he went to be with the Lord, he came to the continent of Africa, Nigeria precisely. And he walked around certain territories around Nigeria. The last place he went to was Lagos. And while he arrived Lagos, he made a prophecy to the great man of God, Pastor Chris. He said he will be the one God will use to bring the body of Christ together. It's called the unity of the body. He said, and as soon as that happened, he brings the close of the age. And for the first time, a global service has been held. That more than 3 billion people follow. Is prophecy already fulfilling? It is. It is. And as soon as he dropped that prophecy, he didn't stay for more than 4 months again. He went to be with the Lord. Brothers and sisters, you are going to see the essence of all of these things I'm saying now at the end of my teaching. I'm showing you this for a reason. We are in the midst of prophecy. We are right in the midst of the prophecy. You have to be excited to be alive in this age and time. You have to be. And listen, our exit from the world is not going to be a sneaking out. No. Let me explain to you. We are not going to escape out of the earth. We are not going to fizzle out. We are not going to calmly escape the earth. No. It's going to be a glorious exit. Glorious exit. It will happen in the similitude of what happened in Egypt. When the Israelites were about to leave Egypt, you know how it happened. Let me show you 3 things that will characterize our exit. Number one, that will be a terrible manifestation of power. Real demonstration of power, like it happened in Egypt. It will be so powerful that it will humiliate the gods of the Egyptians. In this age and time, we will see occultic men coming to give their life to Christ. They are going to see something that is true, what they've seen. Real demonstration of power. Here and there, I've seen people criticize men of God. Is this power real? For many of you, the little things that are just happening now, you are surprised what kind of thing is this. You've not seen anything. Compared to the dimension the church is coming into, there is real power about to be released. The church is going to step into it. Believe it.
is going to be one of the things that will characterize our exit. Real demonstration of power, not for men of God, even our children. Not for men of God, even our ushers. Not for those on the pulpit, even our businessmen. Number two, in this age, it is going to also be characterized by a massive transfer of wealth. Somebody say amen. A massive, you know what happened in Egypt. I'm trying to show you how our exit will happen. We are not going to leave the earth poor, broken. No. We are going to exit the earth in a glorious, glorious way. There will be a massive transfer of wealth. There are some of you here. The part you're going to play in this revival is not holding the microphone. The part you're going to play is controlling the wealth of nations. Controlling the wealth of nations. For many of you, that's the part you're going to play. Some of you might be eager to carry the mic. Oh God, I want to preach. God will say, hold your peace. For you, you won't preach. I want to keep you at the background, but you will be the one controlling the wealth. For through prosperity, the cities, the church is not a weakling. There is going to be a massive kingdom wealth transfer. That's one of the things that will characterize the church in this age. It's already happening. Right now, the devil is trying to criticize, to do all kinds of things, making it look like the wealth of the believers is not genuine. But listen, they've not seen anything yet. No, they've not seen anything yet. For many of you, you won't get to your 40s before you become a billionaire. No, you will step into it before your 40s. Kingdom wealth, real kingdom wealth. Real kingdom wealth. To a point, people will see you and think you are a ritual. Of course, Jesus died for it. Jesus died for it. Because in reality, before you rise in this realm, somebody's blood must pay for it. Massive, massive transfer. And number three, God is going to make it happen through favor. I'm just giving you a foundation. He's going to make it happen through favor. People who don't like you will come and give you things you've never bargained for. Just like it happened in Egypt. Real transfer, it will happen through favor. So in this age, God is releasing his last days men. He's releasing his arsenals. He's releasing his army. In this age, the Moses are rising again. The Elijahs are rising again. The Joshuas are rising again. Believe it. The Calebs are rising again. They will be the one to shout, give us this mountain. Give us this mountain. We take the mountain of media. We take the mountain of politics. We take the mountains of families. That's what will be happening in this age. We are not going to be confined to the church. No, the revival is breaking the walls of the church. It's breaking the wall. Listen, the kind of church we'll do in this age is church without walls. Church without walls. Listen, when this start happening, this already happening, no building will be able to contain us again. Our meetings, do you know that the stadiums they are building around the world is for us? Some of you will remember this thing in years to come. Give us 5 years from now, you will remember that I said it. Some of the stadiums they are building, guess who will pack them full? They are the ones seated down here. They are not for footballs, they are for crusades. They are not for footballs, they are for concerts. Putting up worship meetings where thousands and hundreds of thousands will gather to worship, and the literal cloud from heaven will show up. It will happen in this age and time. I'm telling you the things the Lord has showed me. They will happen. They will happen. Church without walls. This is a minister's conference, and I don't want you to begin to think it's just for pastors. No. It's not just for you. Let me tell you who a minister is. Whoever is empowered to advance the kingdom of God. In any sphere, whoever is empowered to advance the kingdom is called a minister. So that when we say a minister conference, we are not saying pastor's conference. For you, you are a minister. As a businessman, you are. These are the things that will happen. So God is releasing his men. A lot of us have been in the cave. God has been working on us in the wilderness. For many of you, you have been in the cave of Adullam. And listen, you don't prepare an army forever. After preparing them, there is an emergence. After preparing them, they are released into the field. It might look like Satan is having his way now, but God is preparing an army. It won't take us long to turn it over, I mean, upside down. We will take territories in one day. We will take territories in a matter of days. Believe it. It has happened before. It will happen again. For these men that turned the world upside down have come to us. They were just entering the city. They had not been there for long. These men that turned the world upside down. For many of us, we will territories and cities in a matter of days. Matter of hours. Believe it. It has happened in church history. It will happen again. It will happen again. So God is releasing his men. He has been training these men. Some of them have been trained around campuses. For many of you, in your little campus, there is a prayer meeting. You are part of it. Just 10, 15 people. You don't even know what God is doing yet. It's not just a prayer meeting. It is a strategy. It is a strategy. Meetings where thousands of young people gather like this. It is a strategy. God's working. He's equipping people. And it's going to be happening. Brothers and sisters, it has started happening in some strategic location of the nation and around the world. And in less than no time, many of you are going to witness what I'm saying. Certain of our children will go to school and shut the school down for one day. Shut it down. Their arrival means it will not happen that day. Let give way to the spirit. Quench not the spirit. It will happen. It will happen. Some of them will be your children. There is an emergence. The Deborahs are rising again. You think we've seen something with the Ketankumans? No. In their thousands, they are rising. Listen, listen. Let me tell you something. You know, in their time, listen. Let me tell you what will character, or what will be the difference between their revival and the one that is happening in this age and time. Please, just help the people wherever you are sitting so that the ushers too can be seated. Let's just have a calm place. Ushers, try to be seated. People are under the anointing around you. Please help them. Their revival happened, and it was usually in locations, and it could be one person championing it in an entire nation or region. But let me show you how it will happen in our time. It's not going to be one person. It will be in the armies in thousands. In thousands. We are no longer going to celebrate miracles in church. The church will be where we gather and share testimonies of what happened outside. Because it will come to a point where we don't have a sick person in our midst. Yeah, it will come to a point you want to pray for the sick in the church. We are all healed. If we don't need healing, we live in divine health in church. So it will be a place of testimonies. While I passed on the street, I saw a guy that could not see. I just stretched my hand and he was healed. It's not for us to clap for you. You are only telling us that it's happening already. It has happened before. It will happen again. So I can see with the eyes of my spirit. I can hear the sound of a church marching, and I hear they are coming in their thousands. They are coming from afar. They are coming from afar. Oh, 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 oh. Listen, it will happen. We are all going here. It will happen, and you will see it. For many of you, you've not come into ministry, and God is saying, calm down. You're not going to preach, oh. I have a... See, don't push yourself into this. If you are not called to preach, don't push yourself, because we will need the wealth that is coming into your hands for crusade. We will need it. Help this young man. We will need it. We will need it. If you are not a preacher, don't preach by force. Listen, evangelism and preaching can happen in different ways. It's not by carrying the microphone. It can happen through the world that is being released into your life. As I speak, when we see these things happening, they are a confirmation. It means what I'm saying is not a lie. It's true. You have to believe it. Lord, I don't like this thing. What is business? I want to preach, and God is saying, remain here. I want to make you be multi-billionaire. Well, transfer. Listen, so many of you will own private jets. How many do you fly per time? You fly one, but you will own private jets. That we are going for a crusade, we go in our mass. Come on now. You don't delay our flight. We have them. Many of you will own airlines. So if we are the one going, nobody delays us. If you say the cloud is not clear, we have in our midst men of power that can clear the cloud for us to move. Shapareko praskitaya. Believe what I'm telling you. We are the army that nothing can resist. I'm telling you, we are the army that no natural law, no spiritual law can stop us. Nothing. For many of you, the things I'm saying, you've been seeing them in your visions, and you're wondering, how can this be? You are not the first to ask that question. He said the Holy Ghost will come upon you, and the power of the highest will overshadow you, and these things can become realities. They can become realities. For it's not by power, it's not by might, but by my spirit. By my spirit. For those of you who are men of God, and you see God using some of your boys in the meeting, in your place, and you are feeling intimidated, no, sir. It's time to challenge them. Let them listen. We are not advancing a church, it's the kingdom. We are not advancing a denomination, it's the kingdom. It is a kingdom. Come on now. After this conference, you can't be a religious man. No. Go back to your place and set fire. Set fire. Set fire. It will happen and we will watch it. I'm telling you. It will come to a point where we will just be two people and send them to a city. Upon your arrival, something start happening. Be seated. Let me even touch our text a little. Brande ko sibraya. So let the fire from your altar touch our bodies. Let the fire from your altar touch my body, Lord. Let the fire from your altar touch our body. Let the fire from your altar touch my altar, Lord. Kabrande ko sabalataya. Let the fire from your altar touch my body. Oh, speak from your heavens, and the earth will hear. Oh, speak from your heavens, and the earth will hear. Oh, speak from your heaven, and the air will hear. Oh, speak from your heavens, and the air. Let the fire from your altar touch our altar.
Let me try to establish something tonight, even if it's just a little in our text, and we make progress. That our impartation is already happening, so you must not expect me to do all of your business later again. Let's just take our time to examine the word of God. God is already touching people. It's not an organized meeting. No, you can find anywhere and sit. In case the place you are is so disorganized, you can find anywhere. The most important thing is that you are part of the meeting. Palabaraba soto balada breaka. Cabraya. Hallelujah. Please be seated. Be seated. Joel chapter 2. Joel chapter 2. Please be seated if you can. He said, blow ye the trumpet in Zion. It's a clarion call. Sound the alarm in my holy mountain. Then he said, let all the inhabitants of the land tremble. For the day of the Lord cometh, for it is nigh at hand. The day of the Lord. Hope you know what the day of the Lord means. The coming of the Christ. He said, that day is near. Sound the alarm. Herald the army. Sound the alarm. The day of the Lord is nigh. Next verse. He said, a day of darkness and gloominess. A day of cloud and of thick darkness. As the morning spread upon the mountain. He tried to describe what will characterize, and it's already happening now. Isaiah 2 prophesied it, that darkness shall cover the earth. Is that in your Bible? And gross darkness the people. And watch this. He said, when you see darkness, you are not supposed to tremble. You are not supposed to be scared. Because in the midst of the chaos, he said, a great people arises. Are you seeing it? It's in your Bible. In the midst of the chaos, in the midst of the cloud, the darkness, the gloominess. When it looks like the gate of hell is breaking loose. When it's like Satan is capturing nations and cities. He said, do not tremble. Do not be afraid. Because God has been preparing a set of people. And then he said, a great people, a strong people. There will be an emergence. Listen, they are not going to be made when everywhere is calm. They are going to be made when the darkness becomes thick. So for everything that is happening now, is truly a setup. Listen, the Bible said the church of God is moving forward. And the gates of hell cannot prevail. Cannot. So a mighty people arises. And look at the next line. He said, there had not been ever the like. Neither shall be any more after it. Even to the years of many generations. He said, we are the one to bring the close of the age. He said, after us. There will not be, and there have never been any army like the one that is arising. If you think you've moved of God in the past, get ready for something new. I know you've read the Ghost Generals, I have myself. We've read the story of many revivals, we've read the story of many moves of God. But look at what the Bible is saying. He said, what is about to happen, the like of it has never happened. Has never experienced it before. Never. Never. You think you have seen mass healings. You think you've seen mass miracles. You think you've seen crusade of thousands and millions. You've not seen anything yet. Something is happening. It's breaking forth. He said the like of it never. 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 And maybe I tell you a little the things that have happened in church history. Listen, in this body of Christ, we've had men who lived terrible lives in righteousness, who did terrible things. Hands, literal hands growing out. Eyeballs being created. They don't exist. Someone comes without eyeballs. The face is just blank.
and then literal eyes have been created. And the Bible is saying all of this put together is not compared to what is happening in our age. Jesus rose Lazarus after 4 days. In church history, a man have resurrected another after 6 months. St. Patrick of Capatino. After 6 months, dig out the grave. They dug out the grave and then he laid his staff on it and commanded the bones gather together and flesh come again and the person resurrected. With all of this, the Bible is saying we've not seen anything. We've not seen anything. We've had 1 million man crusade. We've had crusade where 5 million gathered. But the Bible is saying that's not compared to what's coming. Meaning we will disciple cities for Jesus. I'm telling you, we will enter a city and disciple the entire city for the Lord. The entire city. The like of it has not happened before. We've not seen it in this fashion. They said it about Jesus. And something greater is coming. Because even Jesus said greater works. Greater, greater. Maybe I take one more verse. Greater. There will be a mysterious people. Put on the scripture. There will be a mysterious people. The like of them never before. And he said, fire devoured before them. He began describing this army. And behind them, a flame burned. And the land is as the garden of Eden before them. Meaning they will enter territories that are barren and the doors of city will open. And behind them, a desolate wilderness. And nothing shall escape us. Nothing shall escape us. Very thorough. We enter a city and capture it for the Lord. Nothing shall escape us. Nothing. Nothing. Once. Verse 4. The appearances of them is as the appearances of horses' power. And as horsemen, so shall they run. There is something I'm looking for. It's an like the noise of chariot to the top of mountains shall they leap, like the noise of flames of fire that devour the stubble, as a strong people set in battle array. Next verse. Before their faces the people shall be much pain. All faces shall gather blackness. Verse 7. They shall run like mighty men. They shall climb the walls like men of war. They shall march everyone on his ways, and they shall not break their ranks. They shall not break their ranks. Listen, in this age, competition will not find a space among us. I'm telling you. The word break their ranks means you know what you are called to do, I know what I'm called to do. I might not be calling to the prophetic if it I celebrate you. I might not be calling to the apostolic if you have the teaching grace, I honor you. We are not going to be competing. No, we will compliment. Nobody will. There is no breaking of ranks. No. So that in case you begin to see competition arising in you as a young minister, you should know that something is trying to snatch the mandate of God upon your life. Something is trying to advance the purposes of God over your life. I might not sing at the high pitch, but then I will celebrate the one that has it. Listen, it's going to be the age of order. 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 That you might not have the revelation, but when I discern and I see the grace for healing, I will know your place in the body. I'm going to talk about something like that briefly. Listen, some of our fathers might not have the revelation we have now, but there is something in them we have to honor. We will not break our ranks. We will not break our ranks. We will not break our ranks. No competition, no fighting, no, no, no. We will celebrate the grace of God upon your life. Please be seated if you can. Let me show you 4 things, very brief. Lord, help us tonight. It is in prophecy. It is in prophecy. How do we bet these things in our territory? Because my father, Apostle Selman, have always said that the mandate is global, but the move is territorial. The mandate is global. We are supposed to take the entire world, but then that the move is territorial. That everybody has been allocated a territory. and you are supposed to take that territory for the Lord. So you came from Kaduna, you came from Delta, you came from Adamawa, you came from wherever you are coming from. That territory has been allocated for someone, has been allocated to someone. And you have to believe this. Although we are supposed to win the entire world, but that it is, the assignment is territorial. So in my territory, how do I take it for the Lord? How do I bet this revival? How do I bet these possibilities? Listen to my case very seriously, because now this is the real point. Number one. Passion for souls. There must be a passion for souls. What's your passion for souls? How do you feel when you see people in your territory not born again? When you walk around the streets of your area, of your city, of your town, and you see young people who are not born again, and you see elderly people who are not born again, how do you feel? Is there anything happening to your spirit when you see that kind of thing? And listen, if nothing is happening to you, it means you are far from what we're talking about. You must not be a pastor. No, you must not be a preacher. But if nothing happens to you when you see the lost, when you see the state of your city, then it means you are far from what we're saying. There must be a passion to see the entire city saved. There must be a passion to see the entire nation saved. There must be a passion to see the entire town saved. Let me give you a statistic, and I think this will help you before I close. Some 2-3 years back, a research was taken, and the world's population was 1.2 billion. And 4.7 were still lost. 4.7 were not born again. They were still lost. Let me give it to you wrong, like it was taken. Then 2.5 were Christians. And among the Christians, 1.2 were Catholics. I don't know why we have to divide it this way. We love the Catholics, we are one. We are one. But then this is the research I'm giving you. 1.2 were Catholics. Then 1.3 were those who were real, or who were now Christians. Let's use that word. And out of the 1.3 that were Christians, only 720 million to 800 are Holy Ghost filled. That's like one in out of every 10 in the population of the entire world is Holy Ghost filled. Praying tongues, fiery, one out of every 10. Listen, if you have one over 10 in tests, have you passed? Mark yourself. You have one over 10 in an assignment, did you pass? That's the state of the church right now. Right now. That we only have one over 10 that is truly fiery, that is truly on fire for God. And yet, we go around with this level of rest. Nobody is troubled. And at times, we end up fighting ourselves as ministers. We end up fighting, this guy left my church to that ministry. And you are fighting when the entire city is still walking on the street. Something has challenged me recently. We used to think we have so much overflow around here. When we bought this massive land, are you seeing the land? We packed every overflow inside there. It swallowed everything and told us we are not yet working. Believe it. We used to think people sitting all around this small overflow here. Now this massive land is here. Do you know what came to my heart? Oh God, that means we have work. While the conference was happening, I told them, set the chairs everywhere. Let me tell you something. Do you know that those in Biafalo has more faith than us? You walk around 3 p.m., see where beer parlors are. Their tables are set, although one member has not arrived. They will set over floors and set it everywhere, although one member has not showed up yet. And later in the evening, watch faith walking like a joke. You pass here around 8 p.m., every seat is occupied. Then when it's now your program, you just tell them rank 20 chairs, rank 15 chairs. Come on now, can you wake up? It's better you rent the chairs and nobody sit on them. It will now prove to you it's work needed to be done. Passion for souls. What are you talking about? There must be a passion for souls. My father told me, look at what he told me. He said, Jonathan, the day you told me this, I became sleepless. Jonathan, your assignment is to give God the tithe of your city. I'm helping you now. That's what I was told some 2 years back. Jonathan, you are not yet a great man of God until you are able to take statistics of your city. Then give God the tithe of your city. So if this city is 2 million people, how many people am I supposed to give the Lord? 200,000. And we celebrate a congregation of 1 or 2,000. And the Lord is saying, what are you celebrating? So we can be here and we fight ourselves. That people are not coming. They now are going to the other guy that just came in town. Meanwhile, 99.9% of your city is not your city. You fight. Listen, it is not revival when people only leave another church to another church. It is called revolving. It is revival when you see them leave the street as cultists, as drunkards, as prostitutes, walking into the church and saying from today. And if that has not happened, let me tell you what's happening to us. Revolving. They are revolving around the church. When a man of God comes and is the one that had the current revelation, they leave this one and jump in there. When the other one comes and he has the prophetic, they leave this one and jump in there. It is called revolving, not revival. We are not making progress. We are only running around a circle. We send people. Send people. Give me souls or nothing else. If you enter my house, on every door it is written. My house. Every door. My bedroom. My mirror. My kitchen. My whatever store. Give me souls or nothing else. What is your own cry for souls? If you don't have passion for souls, forget it. Forget it. Everything I shared that the power of God was touching people and you're excited. If you don't have passion for souls, forget it. Forget. So you can successfully pick up a meeting and close that meeting without making an altar call. I'm trying to help some of you. When you get back to wherever it is, never finish a meeting without an altar call. Never. Never. It's better you make the altar call and nobody respond, but let it be marked that you make the altar call. You not making altar call means you didn't have it in mind. Your assignment was not to see life saved. Listen, even as music ministers, when you are invited to a place and you check the spiritual atmosphere of that place and you notice that you are not serious people, don't wait for the guest speaker. Make your altar call within your time allocated. Is that it? Yes. Man of God, we didn't bring you to make altar call, it was to sing. You gave me 30 minutes to sing. You don't have it in your plan to make altar call. I will sing and worship God for 25 minutes. I will use 5 minutes within my time. If you know you are not born again, or your fire is going down, you need, come out, come out. Singing is not just to whatever. It is about advancing the kingdom of God. There must be a passion. There must be a passion like John Knox. Keep the Scotland. Oh, I die. How many of us have prayed that prayer yet for our cities? Give me souls or nothing else. I don't want a car. I don't want a house again. I don't want another whatever. Give me souls. There should be this passion. Passion. This ministry, I've said it a couple of times, was built on the strength of passion for souls. You can be seated. I remember in my school days, 100 and 200 level, 300 level. I woke up every night to pray for young people around the campus. Oh Lord, especially when I walk around and I see them carelessly dressed around, smoking and doing all kinds of things. I go straight to the court and I will start weeping and crying. Oh God, this campus, I will pray for every fellowship there. Although I was not attending all, it was passion. Passion. I woke up every night to intercede. Passion for souls. You have to sustain it. or a man of God. I'm not a pastor. I'm just an ordinary person. Yesterday after the service, I saw people who travel from various states. A dear lady, I think from Adamawa also. Imagine, she's not a pastor. Just traveled all the way to attend this conference. It's called passion. Look at this. I'm trying to use her life for an illustration. Do you know she can go back to her city, her town where she is, and decide to start praying every oh God, this city must be saved. This city must be saved. Revive this city or I die. Something must happen here. I know I'm not a pastor, but Lord, you can raise others and use them. My assignment is to be the midwife. My assignment, I might not be known. I might not be the one holding the microphone, but I will labor in the place of prayer. I will intercede for souls until I see the move of God in my city. Can we have women again in this place? Young ladies with makeup, but they know how to make up the destinies of men. That with your makeup, you can kneel down for 1-2 hours every day. And all you are doing is, Lord, give us this city or nothing else happened. Candero Saclati. Reko Sataya. Leprata. Intercession. I'm already going into the next. Because if you truly have passion for souls, it will move you to the place of intercession. Intercession. I'm not talking about the prayer of asking God for money. No. No. They that turn many to righteousness shall be as the stars. A lot of us want to be stars in this kingdom. A lot of us want to be famous. A lot of us want to be known. The easiest way to be a star, make up your mind to turn many to righteousness. I shared with the workers here, the Lord told me the easiest way to go around the world is Mark 16:15. Go ye into the world. And what? That as soon as the gospel is on your lips, every nation must open to you. When the gospel, the good news is on your lips, and you are determined to advance this kingdom, every city, every nation opens. It opens. What is your passion for souls? We have consoled ourselves for too long. Where two or three are gathered, I am there in their midst. Even Jesus that rode that place, it was not two or three people that followed him. I studied the book of Acts, Mark. More than 19 times in the book of Acts, wherever Jesus went, multitude. At the riverside, multitude. On the mountaintop, multitude. In the house, multitude. There was no one place Jesus, even when he didn't want anybody to know he has arrived, multitude were waiting. Is that it? Then you now, the scripture you like is wherever two or three are gathered. You are using that to console your failure and laziness. Wake up. Wake up. The Bible says in Proverbs that in the multitude of the people is the king honored. That your king only honored when crowd gathers. So don't tell me where two or three are gathered. No. Then we hear this again like some people are called to be kingmakers. How many kings have we made so far? How many kings? We want to see Billy Graham's arising again in this age. We want to see the Rehoboamkes again arising in this age. I'm telling you, we want to see the E.R. Deboes arising again in this age. With passion for souls. Passion for souls. The zeal of my father's house consuming me. That's that dimension. It's high time not to fight anybody. Take the city. I vow to myself, I can never fight anybody for nothing. No. Imagine the crowd in this city. Imagine the crowd. Do you know that in this city, even if you gather 10,000 people here, 50,000, that will still be people on the street? I think 2009 or thereabout, when the Habonki came to, it was around Cairo here. Very close, Gwandara here, just around here, there is a place. Some of you are aware of that coming. When he came for that crusade, I was in that crusade, but guess what? While I was going to that overflooded crusade of maybe 1 point or 2 point something million, there were still people walking on the streets. Thousands still walking on the street, and I told myself, that means this city is something else. Brothers and sisters, there is no point fighting anybody. Take the city. Take the city. Take the city. The next is intercession. Intercession. When there is this passion for souls and you want to see the move of God, prayer. Intercession. Help the young person come back. A lot of us pray, but most of our prayers are selfish prayers. Oh Lord, more power. There is nothing wrong with that. Oh Lord, more platforms. There is nothing wrong with that. Oh Lord, more favor. Nothing wrong with that. Bless me. Bless my father. Bless my mother. There is nothing wrong with that. That's why we have miracle services. But that you will touch the heart of God if your prayer becomes for souls. You will touch the heart of God. You will bet a revival. You will become relevant in what God is doing. One of our dear ladies here, guess what? She just got serious with God, I think around March. And between May, around May, she started praying every day, 3 hours. I remember starting to just discuss with her about souls and how that if everybody can go into this. And she said, so what have I been doing with my life? And don't think she's a broke lady. Very established, a medical doctor, very established. So it's not about the problem. She goes to work every day. So it's not about business. She goes to work and close by 4 or 5. But every day she prays for 3 hours for souls, every day. And this is the amazing part. Once in a month, I'm sharing this to challenge some of you, once in a month, she has something she called 12 hours on my knees for souls. Once every, not prayer for power, she goes on her knees and prays from 6 a.m. to 6 p.m. on Saturdays. Oh Lord, souls. Souls. She's not a preacher. She told me, Daddy, I don't even want to marry a preacher. I don't fancy it. I just want to love God. I don't want to be a preacher. Every month she does that. There are pastors that never pray for souls. Never. Never. All of you is either binding demons, asking God for breakthroughs and favors, asking God for the next available, whatever. And God is saying, while my people perish, you are asking for money. My people are perishing, you are asking for money. One of the easiest ways to touch the heart of God is to become an intercessor. Because God the Holy Ghost and God the Son are all intercessors. Meaning two thirds of the Godhead are intercessors. Is that in the Bible? Jesus is at the right hand of the Father making what? Intercession. Romans 8:26. We know not how to pray, but the Spirit helps us. With groanings, supplications that cannot be uttered, intercession. Meaning the Holy Ghost is an intercessor. Jesus is an intercessor. When you become one, you touch the heart of the Father. I'm telling you, easily. Prayers for souls. Oh Lord, give me this city. Oh Lord, give me my city. Oh Lord, my family. There are some of you, the assignment over you is your family. There are people in your family not born again. Can it start from your home? Can it start with your uncles? Can it start with your parents? Let me show you how this thing works. There was a guy called Charles G. Finney. He had two terrible guys that were his team of intercessors, two terrible guys. One of them was Nash, I think the other was Clary or something like that. Two of them. Whenever Charles G. Finney was coming into a city, Father Nash will call his friend. Two of them will go to that city 2 weeks before his arrival. 2 weeks. They will go and look for a room around here or look for anybody that can give them a room. These two people will enter that room. And for 5 days, they are groaning. They are praying for that city, praying for souls. If you by the window, all you keep hearing is you won't even hear the word. It's called groanings. You won't even hear the words. They are groaning and praying. They will do that for days, maybe 14 days. And guess what? When the real preacher enters town, Charles G. Finney, upon his arrival, the entire town starts crying. Repentance. Does Gfinity used to print posters like we do these days? Massive billboard. Nobody is coming. Massive publicity. The whole place is empty. Does Gfinity have time for all of those nonsense? Posters are important, but he didn't have time. All he does, he enters the city, and upon his arrival, people start weeping. All of them will come out and start following him. He will lead them to the hall where the service is happening. Is that not a good way to do publicity? That your presence is what makes the publicity happen. People start following. Another of them was a Moody. A man till his 75th year when he died. Every night he prays for 3 hours. Every night. Even at 75, every night. And listen, when D.L. Moody comes in a place, he came to a point here, he had to enter places hiding. One time he entered a train, and while he's sitting down on the train, he had to cover his face so that nobody would know he's around. And while he's sitting down covering his face, ensuring nobody knows, people start falling from the train, falling inside the train, falling. Shaking and falling up their chairs. And somebody asked, what's happening in this train? Why are people falling? Guess what the woman said? It's like DL is in this train. Because anytime he comes in the city, this is what happens. It's like DL is in, check around this train, that is DL Moody. And like a joke, they search around, he's seated down somewhere. You know what? One of the prayers I want to convert in the life of my father, Apostle Joshua Selman, is that one that he enters a city and shut down that city. Announce that he's coming to this city. You won't know where people are coming from. It will cause emergency traffic. It has started. The revival I'm talking about has started. I must carry that grace. Oh, no, I'm telling you. I used to tell the Lord, I belong to this tribe. If it does not happen, that means I'm a vagabond. And I'm not. We make noise over things that are not even happening. Brothers and sisters, if we can go back to the place of real intercession. You know, many of us like the story of Patrick Kuman. Let me tell you one of our secrets. William Branham didn't used to like women preaching. He disliked it. He was one of those that believed that women should be silent in the church. So he had with Catherine Kuhlman preaching. He didn't like it. The first day he entered the office, the house of Catherine Kuhlman, he stood there transfixed. He stood there. The presence of God held him stand still. And guess what he said? Indeed, in this house, there is a woman that groans and prays. Groaning. He knew it by the atmosphere he encountered. Groaning. I'm sharing these things with you because I've taken a little time to study the lives of our fathers. I've studied some of their lives. I heard Pastor Chris of Christ Embassy saying, if you are a man of God, you are praying for souls, and you've never cried in the place of praying for souls, you are not called yet. Think about it, because when I heard it, I had to think twice. You've never been moved to tears in the place of souls. You are not even called yet. We only see the glory, and we don't know what the glory is to. Many of them in the place of prayer, they groan, they cry. Souls are not yet. If you are not part of this class, you can never take any city. Believe me. You can never. I'm giving you a prior information. God might use others, but not you. No. Others might come into that city and take it, but not you. You might see the revival, but for you, you won't be part of it. You have to be part of this class. Ask men who took this. You don't take city with English. No. You don't take cities by suit and tie. No. You don't take cities by pocket square. You don't take cities by organized native like the one I'm wearing. Forget it. Demons don't recognize dressing. There are gatekeepers in every city. Are you aware? God help us on that. There are gatekeepers in every city. Every city. When you enter a city and ministry is not growing, brother, it's not because you can't preach. There are people, the revelation you have is better than their own. But they are gathering crowd. There is something about your laziness. I'm preaching globally, apostolically. So don't feel bad. Just get challenged and do what is needful. Our father, Iyadebo, is having a crusade, having a program. In the night, he goes around that place. Nobody sees him. He walk around that stage, behind the stage. This is how he walk slowly. From night around 10 down till around 5 a.m. walking around and praying behind the altar, praying while others are burying things in their altars. And here is the cheapest secret: pray there. He has just producing results. Many people have traveled to Zaria again and again. Zaria has become like a place of pilgrimage. But ask the man who is here, what he has personally has told me, that are things he had to fight in Zaria. He has seen the spirit of death. There are no kinds of things he has not seen. Listen, you will collide with forces. For you to take a city, you don't take it because you are nice. No! I heard something that made me cry some short time ago. A father in this nation, a young father actually, happened to storm into Kefi. When he came to Kefi, guess what he said? I cried. He said, a city without a father, an ancient city without a father, because I want to pay the price. No man is willing to pay the price. So Kefi is there. No father. We are only there. I remember when I heard that, I remember telling the Lord, this is a minister's conference, allow me to just share things. Am I permitted? I remember 2009, 2010. Then when I went to Zaria the first time, 2013, I came back to Kefi and I was crying. I told the Lord, we don't even have a father in this land. Look at Zaria, at least my father is there. You mention some strategic places of Nigeria and the campuses. You can pinpoint someone. In Kefi, we don't have one. Lord, what are you doing here? And the Lord told me, I'm still looking for somebody who is willing to pay the price. I'm telling you, I heard it. Only for me to hear this few years back, that another man of God that didn't hear my cry stumbled into Kefi, and that's the first thing he said. An ancient city. It has to develop an ancient city without a father, because no one is willing to pay the price. Many of us are like that in cities. The only ministries that are thriving are ministries that are leveraging on track record of their fathers. They are like branch ministries. But if you are coming in afresh, you don't excel, and you are wondering what's wrong. Nobody wants to pay the price. Nobody wants to pay the price. You wonder why pioneering ministries are not even growing. We like organization. We like excellence. So we have to have an organized, everything will have to be organized. We don't want anything to scatter before it will make it look like we are not excellent people. Excellence is good, don't get me wrong, we are trying our best here. Except that we drop the needful and carry all kinds of things that are not even it. What's the need of excellence when no one is getting done again? I was talking to a young person some days back, and I asked her, when last did they do an altar call in your church? It was not a discussion. She said, Apostle, I can't remember the last year altar call was made in our church. The last year. Yay! Yay! I went to a program sometimes, but listen. And I forgot to do altar call. My God! My God! You don't want to see me that day. I mean, I finished preaching the power of God everywhere. People were healed. All kinds of things happened. And at the end, I handed over the mic without altar call. I when I got up, that's when I remembered I didn't. No altar call. No. I trekked through that night. Yes, my prayer. Those who were supposed to get born again, oh God, please, please, convict them. They must enter a meeting within these days that get them born again. Oh God! It became a burden and a cry. Somebody can finish a meeting. A meeting where 30 people gathered, at least 60 people were not born again. For you, it was not an issue. They are gradually losing it. But my joy is that a generation is arising. No, a generation is arising. prayer of instantation. You must not be a pastor to do this. Lord, give me my city or I die. Some of you, this will help you to be the prayer point you are returning back home with. Lord, give me my city or I die. Give me my city or nothing else. I don't want anything again. You release a single. Listen carefully, music ministers. And then you upload it. The question is not how many people downloaded it yet. It's important. But the question is how many people will get transformed, saved by this song. There are people whose prayer life is going, will they listen to this and their challenge or not? If nothing happens, forget it. Nice lyrics, nice organization, but nothing happened to anybody. That's still a problem. We are not making progress. We are not. I fear the prayer of John Knox more than the entire armies of Scotland. It was not a prayer of casting out devils, mind you. Taking territories. Taking territories. Let me run through just two more and then we'll pray. The mystery of signs and wonders. The dimension of God's power is one of those ways we can trigger this revival in our cities. Take our cities. There are people who will never believe gospel until they see the sign. They will never believe, never, never, until something happens that is beyond their entire concept about God, entire knowledge about God. They will not believe. Let me tell you something. Pharaoh will never bow to you because you went to school. Pharaoh bows to power. There must be something we have. Signs and wonders. Me, I'm just called to be a teacher of the word. What's your definition of that? Acts 1:1. Writing to Theophilus, of all the things that Jesus both began to do and to teach, not just doing, teaching and doing. There should be a provision where you are teaching the word of God and cancer disappears. There should be a problem. I know you are a teacher. I know you are a word, whatever it is now. But as you are teaching, there should be a provision that somebody with all sides being here. A little Bible study. While you are teaching, something should happen. I've received testimonies again and again. All kinds of healings happening in the prayer department meeting. That's what is expected. That's what is expected. There should not be. You shouldn't come for a departmental meeting and you were sick and you go back sick. It's not possible. Real signs and wonders. Our world is full of troubles and problems. And they are not willing to listen to us until there are signs. Look at the name he calls us. Acts of the Apostle 1:8 projected for us. And you shall receive power after that the Holy Ghost is come upon you. Everybody, the next line, want to read. And you shall be what? Witnesses. Just stop here. Stop here. My father did a message on the witness. You can listen to it, but listen carefully. A witness is not the one that comes with English. It's the one that comes with evidence. So you come and tell me Jesus is alive and Jesus can settle the situations of your family. Thank you. I've heard that again and again. I want to see resolve. I want to see resolve. It's time where our messages come with power and grace. I'm telling you, it's high time where our worship is a meeting with power and fire. Where you are singing and you know you are not alone. You know there is an agency backing you up. You bring the word of God like this, and there are signs happening among the people.
Let the fire from your altar touch my body. Let the fire from your altar touch my body. Let the fire from your altar touch my altar. Let the fire from your water, touch my body. Let the fire from your water, touch my body, Lord. Yeah. Let the fire from your water, touch my body, touch my body.
We are, our messages come with power, our songs come with power, and what the songs you write will not just be because you sat down and intellectually wrote the songs. No, you receive them, and wherever the songs are sung, the same atmosphere you receive them with permeates that territory. Have you noticed that there are certain songs, anywhere you see them, you tend to see the same reaction? Same reaction. They are not normal songs. Signs, wonders. And let me tell you, one of the ways to truly walk in signs and wonders, in case you know that you don't even know how to access this, look for a lineage that has it as their inheritance. I am the sons the Lord has given me are for signs and wonders. Listen, there are things I see in the lineage I belong, and I don't have to cry about it. I only say, oh God, can you see? It's a possibility here. And if it is here, I'm not a vagabond. I have a father. It is mine for a taking. I and the children you've given me are for signs. Signs. Because we live in an age where the kingdom of God is not just in words, but is in power. It's in power. It's in power. It's in power. Make up your mind. And listen, you don't have to trouble yourself. Because many of you, let me help a little of you. I minister to people, I don't see the power of God. Well, how? When you do it today and nothing happened, try it again. We grow in grace. Are you aware? All right, all of you at the front, stand up. Just stand. Hold your hands together, drop the Bibles and everything. Hold your hands. Let me show you something. Hold your hands together. In years back, this was not a possibility. I tried it, it did not work. But watch this now. Lift your hands. Father, in the name of Jesus, let fire come on them from the first to the last. Are you watching this? Are you watching this? This was not a possibility some years back. No, and I knew it. But I did not stop. I did not stop. I did not stop. That a lot of the first day you stretch your hand to pray for someone, it looked like nothing happened, and then you were discouraged. Don't be discouraged. I remember when I started learning to walk in grace like this, I saw it somewhere. I desired it. I knew it was possible. People will be standing from where those guys are standing. Watch this and see. Lift your hands where you're standing there. Lift your hands. And the Lord will tell me, stretch your hands and see what happened. And I will stretch my hand like I'm doing now. And in the name of Jesus, watch it. Are you seeing it? Are you seeing it? Where to the back? Where to the back? Where to the back? Where to the back? Don't be distracted. Please pay attention. Pay attention. I'm still teaching. Pay attention. That you tried it once and it did not happen does not mean you should give up. No. Try it again. Try it again. I've told you some times back that this kingdom, if you want to pray once and see the result, don't even bother praying. Even Jesus prayed 3 times. If it's your will, let this cup pass. The cup did not pass. Did he pray again? He prayed again. He prayed again. Pray again. Pray again. Stay in the place of prayer. It must become your reality. It has to become. It has to become your reality. Signs and wonders. Real power. I mean, real power. It will be a requirement in this last day. Otherwise, we will make a mockery of ourselves. I'm telling you. We will make a mockery. We will make bold claims that we don't have a way of proving them. I'm telling you. We will say things that we can't prove. God can make a lump dissolve. Oh, yeah. God can give you a breakthrough in 24 hours, oh yeah, man of God. God can announce you in 2 months, oh yeah. Stop, stop. Make it happen. Stop giving us English. We live in the age of results. Everybody wants to see results to believe what you are saying.
And if you keep making noise and they are not seeing, they will soon be tired. People have too many problems to hang around when there is no result. Please be seated if you can.
They have to be. Decide the kind of man of God you want to be. Decide the kind of grace you want to see at work in your life. Decide the kind of believer you want to be. You must not be a man of God to see the power of God. No. When last did you pray with your classmate? When last did you pray with your colleagues at workplace? They come and tell you, I can't sleep for a while now. I've been sleeping this and that. Come on now. Come on now. And you are in that office and you tell them, Have you what? Why are you there? It's an opportunity to present Jesus. Present Jesus. I've not slept for 2 weeks. Why? I've been having all kinds of nightmares. Come on now, tell them Jesus is alive. Do you believe in Jesus? Yes or no? Even if it's no, let me pray. Listen, for many of us, we've had opportunity to win people, and then you sheepishly go away from it. No. They have a challenge, they come to you. It's an opportunity to reveal Jesus. Let's pray about it. We live in that age of real power. I'm telling you, brothers and sisters. Real power. The last, maybe for 5 minutes and then we pray. And close. You should be provoked tonight, but I'm telling you, you should be so changed tonight. Listen, even Jesus, let me tell you, it is not because he could not heal that guy at once. Remember, there was a guy Jesus healed. When he prayed for him, he asked him if he could see. Is that your Bible? The guy said, I can see, but I'm seeing men as trees. Jesus prayed again. You want to pray for every sick person once and they are healed. Because they did not get healed once, you are now discouraged. I won't pray again. Come on now. Come on. Jesus made that happen for your sake. So that you know that if it did not happen today, it can happen tomorrow. Pray again. You are growing in grace. You will come to a point where you don't have to pray twice. Not for that kind of challenge. I'm telling you, we grow in it. We grow. I remember when I started praying for people some few years back, and lungs dissolved. And guess where I saw it from? From my father. I saw that he came for a meeting and all kinds of things were. I said, my God, what is this? I tried it. One person would get it, and after 2 weeks or 2 months, miracle signs, we don't hear that again. One time a lady came and told me, I think it's 3 years back or so, I have a lump, it's just developing and it's growing and it's painful. Guess what I told the Lord? I see an opportunity, practical. The ones that have been getting healed in the crowd, let's even do practical one-on-one. I said, you can feel the lump? Yes, I'm going to pray with you. And I will meet you tomorrow, I think it was at the court or somewhere. Tell me what happened. I prayed for her there. And she went. She came back the following day and said, the pain stopped, but the lump is still there. I said, we're already making progress, yeah? Let's pray again. I prayed again. Later the following day, said, it's like it's just there, but I can't. I said, let's pray again. I prayed 3 times, and the last time she told me there's no longer lump there. The miracle happened. So, you must, it's not, even if you pray once, pray again. Lastly, you want to capture your territory? You want to see the move of God in your territory? Connect to the graces of fathers. This is the last thing I will say, and I've been touching on it a little here and there. Connect with the graces of fathers. Paul the Apostle in Philippians 1:7, he said, for ye are partakers of my grace. Ye are partakers of my grace. Help him. God is not done with him. You can be a partaker of someone's grace. You can be a partaker of the grace that is on the life of a father of faith, a man that have taken it, a man that have conquered his territory. Listen, my father shared this, and it's true. I have an instruction from the Lord. I had an instruction, rather. We've done it again and again, and the Lord came to me recently and asked me to do that. Let me share with you. That when you enter a city, one of the ways to take a city, look for the man that have conquered the city.
There are not usually plenty of people conquering a city. There are not usually plenty. We only have plenty noisemakers. Look for the one that have conquered the city. Package a sacrifice. Go to that one. Drop it there. And then watch that city open for you. There are still men called gatekeepers. You trivialize them in that city, nothing happens to you, serious. I'm telling you. You can connect to those places. And it can happen to you like magic. What am I saying? Like miracle. Say amen. It can happen to you like a joke. I'm telling you this. That every move of God, I've said this a couple of times, let me repeat it. No move of God is independent of the previous. No move. No move. Whatever God is doing now is connected to something he did yesterday. And these kingdom things are usually handed over from one generation to another. The move of God is transgenerational. It does not end with a generation. No, no. The move of God is transgenerational. It is usually handed over. Let me show you this from scripture. What is this? And I will do this and find somewhere to tie up and then tidy up and we pray. Listen. When God appeared to Abraham, he told him, I'm the Lord your God. Walk before me and be perfect. He built and started a covenant with the Lord. When he appeared to Isaac, same Genesis, he told Isaac, I'm the God of your father, Abraham. You know what that means? What I started with Abraham, you are the continuity of it. It did not end with him. You are the one that carries that grace to continue. When he appeared to Jacob, look at what he did. I'm the God of your fathers, Abraham, Isaac. He kept multiplying it, adding it up. No one should be missing. When he appeared to Moses in Exodus, I think the book of Exodus 3 verse 6, guess what he told him? This is God saying it. God himself saying it. I am the God of your fathers, Abraham. What's this? Moreover, he said, I'm the God of thy father, the God of Abraham, the one that moved with Abraham. I was the one that pioneered the move that happened in the generation of Abraham. I am also the God of Isaac, and I am the God of Jacob. And then when Moses heard this, he knew he was the one that takes over from that. That no move of God happens independent of the previous. God will always look for somebody that collects it like a baton for a generation and hand this over. This is very powerful, very powerful. All through, so we see this example. Paul speaking to Timothy, I'm convinced that the grace that was on your grandmother is on you. It started from your grandmother Lois. It came to your mother Eunice. I'm not in doubt. That same grace is on you. Transgenerational. You can leverage on the covenant of fathers, the graces of fathers, and pioneer it in your territory. The emergence of revivalists, the emergence of the army. This is very true. Paul, Timothy. Elijah, Elisha, is that in your Bible? Joshua, Moses, is in your Bible. Even Jesus, let me show you how it worked with Jesus. John 20, 22. This is how it happened in the days of Jesus. Look at this. Please project it for us, help us, media. And he said, and when he has said this, he prayed on them and said to them, receive the Holy. He's about to lead them, and he's transferring what he carries. A transfer. Even Jesus applied this pattern. Even Jesus. It can happen to anybody. It has happened all through. The great man of God that have gone to be with the Lord, Rehabonki. There is someone now that is working in his grace. Is that it? Daniel Colander. That grace didn't fade away. No, it's still there. It's preserved. Somebody will always have to collect it and transfer to the next generation. You can leverage on such possibilities and be mightily used in your age and time. I'm telling you, never trivialize men that work in grace. No, no. Never trivialize our fathers of faith. Many of them might not have the revelation. They might not have the English. They might have the crowd. In fact, many of them have the crowd. But listen, never trivialize them. Never. They are custodians of certain possibilities. And we must not allow them to die with them. No. We must be able to discern these graces. That before they exit, look at Maurice Olulo asking Dr. Paul Imenche, what do you want from me? Did he ask that question? I watched him. What do you want from me? Ask me whatever you want. And he looked at him. He said, your spirit. And he said, you have it. You have it. When you follow a father, I'm already doing the teaching of Wednesday morning. But when you follow a father, don't follow him because of who he is. Follow him because of his spirit. Your father can even give you a car. If a car is all you went for, you will get that car and never carry what he has. Before Idahosa died, let me share a few stories with you at this point and we pray. Before Idahosa died, one time Bishop David Oedeko went to see him with a seed. And his papa, show me, impart me, I want something. And he looked at the seed and said, you brought this seed, come. He went to his garage and at that point it was a very serious thing for you to have cars in your garage. And he asked him, open all the cars, pick the one you want. Guess what Oedeko did? He knelt down. He said, Daddy, I don't want a car. Show me how to get the cars. I know that is something in you. If you give me, cars will look for me. There are a lot of people following fathers. What you see is just the material things. Can you see beyond it? See beyond it. It has been transferred again and again and again and again. From Ketun Kuman to Benny Hinn. And can I show you something? From Benny Hinn, it's now in Nigeria, Pastor Chris. It's now in Nigeria. Now in Nigeria. Transfer. Transfer. Ola Robert, listen. Kenneth Copeland was the one that flew Ola Robert as a pilot, free of charge, no payment. No payment. Before Ola Robert died, he imparted it on Kenneth Copeland. And guess what? As of 4 years back, Kenneth Copeland had given out 27 private jets. Giving out as seed, not sold, not on, giving out. Giving out. And guess what? From Kenneth Copeland, he came on Bishop David Oedeko. Transfer, transfer. You can leverage on these graces, transfer. Many of you have listened to our father's teaching. How that he went to South Africa, right? Many of you have listened to it. I've listened to it a couple of times. Where couples looked for him through word of knowledge and brought him out. He said something fell on Smirugusua to Lester Somra. He fell on Lester Somra and then came on me, couples. And then he told me before I die, I should look for young men and give them these graces. And he said, you are one of them. And he imparted him with that grace. And said, let me connect you to the lineage of generals. And guess what? From Apostle Joshua Selman to Jonathan. He has to follow me. He has to follow me. He has to come on me. I belong to the tribe. I'm telling you. I belong to the tribe. I follow intentionally. This is my teaching for Wednesday. Let me not even go into it. I follow I don't follow because every other person is following. No. Far from it. I follow intentional. I'm intentional about it. And it must happen to me. They said, let it happen to the sons like it happened to the father. It's in your Bible. It's in your Bible. That if it happens to the father and not happen to the sons, there is a problem. There is. You know that when an apostle is teaching in a place, the things that are happening are the things that happen. Is that it? Ask where I got it from. If you don't truly have a father, you are not going far home.
Hari Hari Om.
Hari hari yo. Oh.
Man must have been given to the church. Visions have been given to the church. Mantles are restored to the church. And mandates are released to the church. We'll arise in this age to become like the church in his heart. Hare, hare.
So fired up. I want you to pray the first prayer. Oh God, whatever you are doing in this age and time, don't finish it without me. Recruit me into this army. Don't do it without me. Can you lift the voice and pray wherever you are? Inside and outside, pray. Traveling from far, you are following online. Ensure you are praying. Ensure you are praying. Shake a prateke pralena manesha. Leke proskobe leke tena na 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 mosha. Shake it, shake it, shake it, shake it. Shake it, na 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 na. There is an emergence of the revivalist. There is an emergence. There is an emergence. Get a procoso de legate. She get a procopa legate. Lambro so de get a belarinage. Power Play is a conference where your life must change. It's a conference where your life must change. It's a conference where your life was changed. In a na 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 nation. And Jesus. Hallelujah. One more prayer tonight. Just one more. And I will minister to a few people and we are done. This is a conference that something, you must carry something. No, you must carry something. I've been watching the atmosphere right from the praise and worship. This one is not a normal conference at all, at all. You're going to pray and say, Lord, the passion for souls and the grace for intercession, I receive it now. The passion for souls and the grace for intercession, I receive it now. Can you lift your voice and pray? Come and pray. Come and pray. Say, na 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 na. I receive the passion for souls and the praise for intercession. And I will replace us with the praise and supplication. Shake it, brande, rocco, poco, soto. Shake it, invitations happening, but can you lift your hands? Zekete barada bataya, zombra katete balada ba. Inside and outside, there is invitation happening tonight, and I'm done. The grace of our Father is coming on us. Listen, let me talk to you. Let me tell you something before that. Listen to me. This morning. He communicated with my father and he sent his greetings to everyone. But listen to what the part that concerns you so much. That there is a grace that is coming on everyone in this conference. Believe it. It's part of the things he said. And I want to pray for you. That's all I want to release now. And we are done for tonight. We'll continue from tomorrow. I shared about liberating on the grace of fathers. I want to pray. There is a grace I drink from.
And many of you drink also from that source. Inside and outside, you are following online. There is a release of fire right now. Lift your hands. The same grace that is upon my life, that flows from my father, Apostle Salman. At the count of three, you are going to shout Jesus inside and outside at the overflow. You are following online, and there are going to be massive distribution of graces. At the count of three, you will shout Jesus. One, two, shout Amarekatela. Three, shout Jesus. Take it now. Receive it now. Receive it now. Receive it now. Receive it now. Outside, inside, Shaketeketeka. Leko prodo proskebele de nevesh. Rekeprate kebala de nevesh. Shaketemareketeka. Leko proskopeleketa. Let there be a release of graces. Let there be a release of graces. Let there be a release of graces. In the name of the Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. The Lord is showing me a few people. You came and your desire was to carry the presence of God. That's what you want. That's the only thing that brought you. I want the presence of God. As I talk now, at the count of three, let the fire of God find you out. And let there be an impartation of that grace now. One, two, three. Take it now. Take it. Take it. Take it. Take it. Take it. Take it. Take it, receive it. Shake that barretta. Lento sopa reggaetea. Yande rosso balada. Caraba coto belagatia. Lift the hands wherever you are. Father, I pray for everyone in the name of Jesus. I decree and declare that this passion you've given me for souls and the passion you've given our fathers, may that passion rest on you this night. In the name of the Lord Jesus, may that passion for souls rest on you this night. Beyond fame, beyond favor, beyond open doors, may there be a release of passion for the kingdom. And I pray that let there be a release of the spirit of grace and supplications, the spirit of prayer, in the name of the Lord Jesus. The anointing for signs and wonders. The Bible says, I and the children the Lord has given me, help his young men, are for signs and wonders. I decree now in the name of Jesus, let that grace come on you tonight. Let that grace come on you tonight. The grace for signs and wonders. The grace for signs and wonders. The grace for signs and wonders. In the name of the Lord Jesus. And finally, the grace of God that is resident in this spiritual tribe, may you drink of it tonight. 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 In the name of the Lord Jesus. Go back and never be the same. Go back and never be the same. In the name of the Lord Jesus. Father, thank you for indeed there is an emergence of an army. There is an emergence of the revivalists of this age. In the media industry, in politics, in families, in businesses, in education, in family life, in ministry, in the name of the Lord Jesus. And I pray that before you return back tomorrow morning and evening, may you be open to diverse encounters. May you be open to diverse encounters. May you be open to diverse encounters. In the name of the Lord Jesus, it is done. In Jesus' name. Please maintain the position you are standing. We are about closing. Maintain it. Don't move. You know you are here and you are not born again. Whether from inside or outside, or you want to dedicate your life to the Lord, please, wherever you are, I want you to run and come forward. Even if you are the only person, Run as though you are the only person God is calling tonight. You are in that category. If you are coming from outside, run and come inside. I'm waiting for you. You are from outside, coming from the hall. Come on. Come and meet me. Come. Come. You are saying, I rededicate my life to the Lord. God bless you, my brother. Or you are saying, I've never been born again. Or I was, but I don't know where I am. Join him quickly. Come. 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 He's the one calling you. Yashinan. Yamunan. Sarkinal Jannah. Allow them coming. If you are coming, come. Yashinan. God bless you. Yamunan. Yananan. God bless you. Keep coming. Don't be the last. Here we are, King of glory in our midst. Here we are. Oh, come on, two more times. Keep coming. Gashinan, hey. Sarkin Jen, yeah. If the Lord is talking to you, come. If you are feeling embarrassed, ask your friend to come with you. Ask your friend to escort you and come with you. One more time, Gashinan, yeah. You are kneeling before the Lord. Can you pray after me? Say, oh God, I come to you tonight. I believe in Jesus Christ. I believe he died for me. And today, I receive by faith eternal life into my spirit. And from now, I'm a child of God. I'm born again. Thank you, Lord, for saving me. I'm born again now. Amen. You truly are. Father, I pray for your sons and daughters. I decree that the name of the Lord be named upon you. Let Satan lose ownership and claims over your life. And from today, a new beginning has come for you. May the Lord so plant your feet and establish you in this grace. No more going back. Whatever has the capacity of keeping you back, I break up that hold over you. In the name of the Lord Jesus, it is well with you. In Jesus' mighty name. Amen and amen. God bless you. I love you for this decision. I want you to stay close. Some of you are weeping. Don't be ashamed of your tears. It's one of the most important decisions you can ever take. From today, you will be rooted and planted in this grace. In Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Please, can you be on your feet? Trust me on your God bless you. God bless you. Please, you will take this way. Our officers are outside to attend to you. Just take this way. Take this way. God bless you. Go with them. Just go this way. Just go with them. Go this way. This way. This way. They are directing them. This way. Let them take this way. This way. It will be easier for them to go out. God bless you. God bless you. Come and celebrate them. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. For me, this is one of the major essence of this meeting. Are you celebrating the Lord?
We hope you've been blessed by this message. Keep walking in grace. For additional information, follow us on our Facebook page, or you could visit us on our Telegram page, Family Worship Experience International.